Good morning, students. This is the last segment of the entire development of coelomic cavities, intraembranic coelom. So our subtitle will be development of the entire peritoneal sac or peritoneal cavity. Note it down. And here we go with the peritoneal sac on my left hand side. Draw the diagram initial stage, then we'll gradually note down the points as we keep on drawing the diagram. So draw alongside with me the last diagram of the peritoneal sac. The entire peritoneal cavity is developing into various structures. For that we need to draw first the whatever things which we have completed. For example, here I start with the pericardial sac. White color line shows the pericardial sac. Now what I want to show is from here, this pericardial sac, there will be development of pleural cavities. So here I go, and these pleural cavities, by this time they have enlarged in a huge manner, and at this level we show that there will be, first you complete this line, this will be almost the development of diaphragm. Now break this line at this level and at this level, we need to break it. Then what we need to show is here there will be an opening. This is an opening, so you mark it with an arrow. Here also, this is an opening, so mark with an arrow. These two will be the pleuroperitoneal canals. What we show here will be in the median plane. I just highlight it with green color. This will be the septum transversum. This will be the septum transversum. Here I will highlight it with the green color, septum transversum. Then we go to the pericardial sac. In the pericardial sac, as we know that from posterior side, there will be the invagination of the entire heart tubes. We know that. So with yellow color, we show the invaginated portion of the heart tubes. And these are the heart tubes. We leave it like this. Then what we show is dorsal to the heart tubes, that is what we have learned yesterday, dorsal to the heart tubes, there will be the trachea, that is with once again green color, laryngotracheal tube. So
here I will show the
laryngotracheal tube. I am going to show the laryngotracheal tube. Of course this will be behind the heart tubes,
this will be
behind the heart tubes, and we show that this laryngotracheal tube will pass posteriorly, posterior to the heart tubes, and what we need to show will be a very light line, and then we will show that first we'll extend this below. We'll try and extend this structure below so that we should be able to guide it at this level. Then we show that these are the two divisions of the bronchi and the future lung buds. Now we create these two lungs. From these lung buds, we will create these two lungs. So this is how the entire laryngotracheal tube will develop into these two lungs. And here I will write as lungs. These are the lungs. Pleural cavity. We need to mention this as pleural cavities on both the sides. These are the pleural cavities, and here we need to mention this as pericardial cavity. Pericardial cavity. This green color structure, we need to mention it as laryngotracheal diverticulum. Yesterday we have marked this yellow color structure. This will be the heart tube. So ventral is heart tube, dorsal will be laryngotracheal diverticulum. Yesterday we have studied all these structures. Now we come lower down, and of course these two structures over here, if I fill those two structures with pink color, what should it suggest? These two structures are nothing but pleuropericardial membrane. So these two structures are pleuropericardial membrane, which I am coloring. I'm coloring it with pink color. And these two pleuropericardial membranes, they will contain common cardinal vein and phrenic nerve. So, common cardinal vein and phrenic nerve. Yesterday we have once again learned these structures. Septum transversum, pleuroperitoneal canal, and this will serve as a thickened portion. Again, I'll give it as pink color, pleuroperitoneal membrane, pleuroperitoneal membrane, pleuroperitoneal membrane. Here also, I will thicken it as pleuroperitoneal membrane. Now, this is the peritoneal cavity. We enter the peritoneal cavity. In the peritoneal cavity, what we need to show is that initially this peritoneal cavity, it is passing down, it is a continuation here from pleuroperitoneal canals, it will continue down. And this peritoneal cavity, remember one thing, it is divided by dorsal and ventral mesentery into two equal half, right half, left half. Now the same thing, the same right and left half, I'm going to show it on that side because of lack of space here. So this entire segment, I'm going to show it over here. I start from septum transversum. This will be the septum transversum, pleuroperitoneal canals. Then pleuroperitoneal membrane, this will be the pleuroperitoneal membrane on both the sides. Then I will complete this side, the lateral sides here, and this lateral sides as the peritoneal sac. This will be the peritoneal sac. Remember, the segment below this is a continuation over here. You can draw it in your whole full sketch page. So here, what I need to show is that this peritoneal cavity, initial stages, it is divided into right and left half by the attachment of dorsal mesentery and ventral mesogastrium. Remember, during general embryology classes, I have discussed with you, the entire primitive gut tube is attached to the dorsal abdominal wall by dorsal mesentery as well as to the ventral abdominal wall by ventral mesogastrium. Now, because of this attachment of the dorsal mesentery, here we are showing that it is attached dorsally, dorsal mesentery, the entire peritoneal cavity, the entire peritoneal cavity is divided into right and left equal parts. These are the lateral walls of the entire peritoneal cavity. Above the peritoneal cavity, in the median plane, comes the pericardial sac, which is partitioned by septum transversum. On its two lateral sides, above the peritoneal cavity, the two lateral sides are occupied by now development of the lungs. The lungs are maturing. So the lungs are covered by pleural cavities. So here, above it will be the pleural cavities. Therefore, name of this canal will be pleuroperitoneal canal, and the name of this membrane will be pleuroperitoneal membrane. This is the basic framework of our peritoneal cavity. So, therefore, now at this stage, I will show here that this structure is the development of stomach. This is the development of the stomach. Roughly at this level, the stomach will develop. And here, I am going to write it as S. Stomach will develop here. And this is dorsal mesentery. So within the dorsal mesentery, what I'll show is, it is occupied by, I will draw it as orange color. It is occupied by the entire gut tube. This is the entire gut tube, and of course the stomach will develop from gut tube. So I will outline the stomach also, and this is the entire gut tube, which is attached to the dorsal abdominal wall by dorsal mesentery. And of course, in the initial state, the entire blood tube is longitudinally placed, sagittally placed, coming from above till below, foregut, midgut, hindgut. So therefore, this is the entire gut tube before the rotation of stomach. During the development of stomach, we have seen that the stomach rotates 90 degrees on the right side. Before the rotation of stomach, this is the diagram where the stomach will initially start its development as a fusiform dilatation. Now, after drawing this diagram, what I want you is, we will add two features here for the development of lesser sac. After drawing this diagram, I want that you note down the points in sequence. So, here, our first point will be, please note it down, there will be development of dorsal mesentery and ventral mesogastrium, which will attach the primitive gut tube to the dorsal abdominal wall and ventral abdominal wall respectively. Next point will be, because of the attachment of dorsal mesentery, the entire peritoneal cavity is divided into right and left parts. Third point will be, during the first stage, there will be development of two pneumoenteric recesses. They are called right and left pneumoenteric recesses. Spelling will be P, will be silent. They will develop within dorsal mesentery of esophagus. So therefore, coming back to this diagram, after writing this much, see here, in this diagram, above the stomach is esophagus. So therefore, within this space, there will be development of right and left pneumoenteric recess in the dorsal mesentery of esophagus. Now write down, next point, very important. Out of these two, right and left pneumoenteric recess, there will be disappearance of left pneumoenteric recess. So therefore, right pneumoenteric recess will remain. Now we draw here the right pneumoenteric recess. Blue color I am going to use. And this, please draw this line. This shows the right pneumoenteric recess. And mark it as here, the right pneumoenteric recess. This much you mark. Then next point, note it down. This right pneumoenteric recess is divided into two parts. With the formation, with the development of diaphragm. Yesterday we have seen the diaphragm is completed by septum transversum and the pleuroperitoneal membranes. Then next point. The right pneumoenteric recess, as it is divided by development of diaphragm into two parts, the superior part, the inferior part, or it is called supradiaphragmatic, infradiaphragmatic. Then you write, the supradiaphragmatic part of right pneumoenteric recess will disappear. It will appear, or sometimes it remains in mature adults, as infracardiac bursa. Note it down, one mark sentence answer MCQs. And the infradiaphragmatic segment of right pneumoenteric recess, it will remain as the upper recess of lesser sac, the upper recess of omental bursa, both are one and the same.